Alright, here is my second part of this, the tactical phase of NBA 2K13, as opposed to the strategic layer that I discussed yesterday. Well, not yesterday, part one. It's yesterday for me, but you don't know that. Alright, so I'm going to play this game and talk to you about why the act of playing is as compelling as the playing basketball manager aspect. So, I've wanted to play the Hawks because they have Magic Johnson. I think I discussed the end of the last video. One thing I want to show was the jerseys. I never got around to do that. So, here you can see all the different jerseys that I made sure in the game. This includes short length. There are three different lengths of shorts that you can use in the game. There are the nut huggers of the 80s and before, and then the sort of mid-length above the knee shorts of the 90s and the super baggy shorts of today. And I'll show you some of those. You can see, like, this is an imaginary alternate jersey. Then you have the Fort Wayne Pistons and various others through history. I tried to add dates to them wherever possible. But for the Pistons, I think I'm going to do this alternate jersey. The Motor City Wanderers is new this year, so it wouldn't be an NBA 2K13, but it might be an NBA 2K14. But a mod will do it here. And the Hawks, I'll go with an older jersey so you can see some of the shorts. Here's a very classic jerseys. Can go even shorter and older, but these are pretty boring. Here's classics. The crazy H there. Alright, so let's go to the game.
Welcome to the NBA here on 2K Sports. It's Monday Night Basketball. It'll be Greg Monroe and the Detroit Pistons facing off against the Atlanta Hawks. And now we head out to Atlanta. Kevin Harlan and the 2K crew for today's broadcast.
It's an all-Eastern Conference matchup in today's game as the Pistons come into town for this one. Bringing you some fun on a Monday night, it's the NBA on 2K Sports. Kevin Harlan here along.
I don't know why Kyle Singler looks like that in this.
The Hawks still playing on their home court in this one. This indeed is a tough time for them right now, trying to figure out how to win games. Only one win in their first nine starts.
And, you know, before the season, we heard them talking about how they were going to prove people wrong because most of the predictions...
So here you can see the different lengths of the shorts.
But that hasn't
super
been the
baggy
case
versus
so
above
far.
The knee.
They've really struggled out of the gates.
And, you know, Steve, say what you will about their talent and whether it's up to par with the rest of the league, but what I've noticed is the basic attitude surrounding this team. And I just have not seen a lot of fire from them in the early going.
So it's Gasol on the bench.
All right.
This is the group Lawrence Frank adds in right now.
So the key thing about playing this is to try to create open shots. I don't play with the
and for the Hawks. Brandon Wright is out there with Big Smooth.
Play with the timed shooting, where the default is if you, you know, release the shot at the top of your jump arc, then you have a better chance of scoring. I don't play with that. It's only open shots that have a better chance for me. So my goal tactically is to create these open shots. I'm going to show you how in a couple ways. Right now I'm just abusing Magic Johnson's size advantage here. But I can't do that every time. But I'll show you my three main. Three main forms of that, and this will kind of help explain why I enjoy the game so much. That is an open three, which is always worth taking.
Off to a nice start here, they hit all three from the field. And Detroit has possession. Follow 3 by Atlanta. Pass to Williams.
Yeah, the basic idea is that I try to make sure that I get open shots. To prevent them from getting open shots, you got a half step there. Alright. So the first way is hold down the left trigger, or the left button, and get the pick and roll. Pick and roll should create open spaces or changes in matchups. Didn't get much out of it there, but salvage something at the end. But basically what happens is the other team has to decide if they want to switch.
His free throw percentage has dropped this year.
And if they do that too slow, or if the pick is strong enough, then the ball handler could just head straight to the basket, which means that someone else jumps over onto him, which means that somebody is open for the open shot. I hope I could do that. Or the ball handler gets the defense on him, and the person who set the pick runs down to the basket and is free for a pass.
Well, it's impossible not to see that domination. Based on the numbers, it was really lopsided in the rebounding battle.
So, let's try this again. Nothing going again. Where's the pick and pop? Are they... There we go.
Johnson outside.
Magic Johnson is kind of a cheat code in this, so it may not be the ideal way to show that, but... I hope you can kind of see what's going on, and maybe I could have someone other than Magic with the ball. Oops. That's a bad defensive move.
Yeah.
I'll give the ball to Ross here to show you. Alright. Call for the pick and roll.
Here is Ross. He's
and
left.
I didn't even get a pick.
Ross gets the right. Stolen by Jeremy Lin.
And you really don't want to give up too many dunks like that. One is too many.
I may not be explaining this as best as I can, or it's difficult to see, but it's possible that if you don't have a pretty good understanding of basketball, then just won't make much sense anyway.
Back to Johnson. Shoots over Lynn. Atlanta again missing.
Well, they'll give him that shot. He doesn't have the most reliable jump shot in the world. We know that.
Knight gets a screen from Monroe. Knight dishes to Singh. Lynn. Pocket six. Over Johnson.
For that time. Nice contested shot.
Excellent job that time staying on.
Open three.
Saran wrap defense there.
The Pistons have gone 50% from the field to this point. 4 of 8. Pass to Monroe. Shoots a fader. No one. So Atlanta will take it the other way.
Alright, so the second thing I can do is I can call a play. There's only ever one play that I call, and it's the 77-3. And I don't have that here. Because they have a coach who doesn't have it. Oh
well.
The 77-3 is just a pair of picks that pops the... player out for what should be an open three. I don't really do any plays other than that. I just do pick and rolls and that, and yes, not good enough for that. So that was an example of what I call the RPG combat of this game, where I basically had a guy moving towards the basket, I told him to shoot, and the game rolled the dice to give me one of the few options where he can score a hit where he gets the basket. He can score a miss, which is what happens. The defense just stood him up. Or can get a critical hit where he gets the basket and the foul. But basically, this is what the strategic element does for me, is that it lets me, that's another example of that there, I got the foul, which is kind of a half hit. It means that the strategic layer, where I try to get the players in the best positions as possible, is like a putting together an RPG party. I want to have a player who can, you know, surprise, surprise. I want to have, you know, a wide range of players so that if I send someone driving down the lane, like I've done on the past couple of sessions, I can have reasonable faith that they've got a good chance of scoring. Atlanta, not being terribly good, doesn't have that. Terrence Ross has that. I don't think any other player does. But, I'll show you my third main offensive thing. Offensive strategy. And I think this will really illustrate the sort of RPG elements here. But first I got to control back.
Well, it's showing up on the scoreboard. I mean, you get second chance points like that, it can add to your totals and also demoralize your opponent.
Here are the five. Detroit has to start the second quarter.
Oops.
They've got Young. Powell Gasol is out there at Paul Nelson. And there's Collison. And it's Singler in at the three.
All right. So there's a quick play you can do, which I do. I just call a post up. And it has my best post up player do this. So then I back in. And I spin. And I try to score. And at that time, it worked. The dice all worked so that you could see via the animations that he was moving past his defender well enough to get a basket. Let's try this again. Post. Back in. Spin. See that he got position, so I got a critical hit that time. Now you can see here that they put, they just subbed Greg Monroe back in, and he is probably going to be a much tougher defender than Paul Millsap, or not Paul Millsap, Pau Gasol, who's much older than this. He's a, you know, average player now. Bad defense by me. So we're going to try this one more time. Now Terrence Ross has been moved in, so the game thinks that he is my best post-up option. So we'll try this again. Spin. You can kind of see in the animation, he didn't get position. So that was not a great choice for me there to make the shot, because I didn't get the animation. Ooh! It's one of the benefits of having Magic Johnson. And there's one of those dice rolls where Ross actually has the ability to go in there. He's got the stats under the hood, and the defender is not.
To when you go through a shooting drop, you might be trying to tell them to get to
make
the free
that
throw
a good
line.
Move.
You know, all teams go cold at points during the game, but the good teams still find ways to score.
And the Pistons making a change here. Paul Gasol's checked in for Monroe.
All right.
Millsap comes in for Derek Williams.
So Josh, now we'll head back to doing the pick and rolls. Damn, Magic. Well, let's do the pick and pop.
Here is Ross. 7 points.
He's not gonna roll.
54. No zap cover. Inside. And he lays it straight in. It's a 10-point match.
So I didn't get a good matchup there, but I did get someone good right under the basket with a clear pass to it.
Back to Gasol. Kicks to Collison. Over Jackson. And there's Darren Collison on the assist by Gasol.
It is a lot more difficult to have the concentration to play defense and trying to talk to you while I'm doing that is.
Johnson outside.
Yeah. Not that I'm the world's greatest. That was a simple pick and roll. The defender there, Paul Millsap, is also dealing with an injury, so he's a easier to blow by there. I play at superstar level, which is the second highest level. I noticed that on the highest level, Hall of Famer, it also often tends to be shot that. The AI just like launches contested fadeaway three-pointers that have no business going in and makes them all the time. But I have also noticed that regular season games, especially home team, are way too easy. Say doubled the opponent's point score here. That's easier than normal, and the Pistons are not a good team right now. But yeah, I think I figured out, you know, after a year of playing this game, I figured out that I can adjust the AI's stats and not my own. And I think I'm going to do that so that some of these can be a little more competitive.
And that game will be game two of three straight on the road. Now the feed to Monroe. Backs in.
The announcers go super generic once you get past the first year. They have a whole bunch of like first year things that they'll talk about, people that they'll talk about. They'll like talk about each team's last season when they, 76ers did this in the playoffs, and we'll see if Miami can repeat as champions again. And that all goes away, and all they ever talk about are free throws. I'm fascinated by the way the announcers kind of tell the story. I have a link to a piece I did for Bit Creature on that.
Out in Atlanta, it's the Hawks taking care of business against the Pistons. Tremendous defensive effort out there. They're challenging every shot, sending them into the third row. The magician playing well in the first half. He has 6 points, and on the defensive side of the floor, he's definitely been contributing with some focused defensive work. And battling nonstop, the Detroit Pistons.
That's
great,
not
energy
true.
And aggression offensively,
no.
Making their own luck with a lot of second chance points. Greg Monroe is making his presence felt early. He's got 4 points and 3 rebounds as well. Let's start things off with a look at what's coming up later tonight. For the
now, it's been a one-team show so far. We'll see if that changes here in the third. Terrence Ross with a strong contribution so far in this one.
We should have changed the court to the older court so you could see what the mod did for that, but oh well. And I would think that he most likely will link to the mod and you can see the screenshots.
While we've got a moment, let's set the floor. Brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up for the second half. On the court right now for the Hawks, they've got Magic Johnson.
So that was an interesting thing where you could see the opposing player had he got the animation to work, but he didn't actually get the shot to go. If you could see someone, you know, tear down the lane like that, they're usually going to make that layup, but not this time, fortunately for me.
Singler's got the first points to start out the third quarter for the Pistons.
You know, it's interesting. Sometimes we're hearing contested shots.
And sometimes you can just have your point guard sprint through.
Get a hand in his face, he seems to relish it. You can't forget about his excellent shooting touch from long range. I mean, he's capable of spreading the floor and absolutely punishing defenders if they're late closing out.
Here's Malone. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up. The Pistons have shot two free throws and only two so far.
And this is a very good free throw shooting team, guys.
See, they're talking about free throws.
And guys, that's a pretty good improvement over last season.
And so he hits both. And now the first timeout called here for the Hawks.
Well, he looks like he wants to toy around with some of his sets and matchups.
You can see that I need to change some of the players' shoes. Like, Pau Gasol over there still has his yellow Laker shoes on. Maryland's Knoll is given those bright blue things that don't fit in. Magic's look fine. So that was a good example of how the pick and roll can work. Didn't actually end up getting the shot because did a crazy pass animation, but you can see that both my ball handler and my roller just blew past defense. Sorry, 3-on-1 heading for the basket.
The dish to Williams. 4 on the clock. Again, they missed by the Pistons.
Oh, that's a frustrating one there. Easy look at the hoop.
Here's Saric, defended by Lynn.
See, there is the pick and roll where I got a third player free. My ball handler moved up. Let's see if I can get a replay, actually. Be able to. Oh well. My ball handler moved up, pulled Magic Johnson's man off of him, and a quick pass to Magic, and I got a slam dunk. Start seeing the shapes as they happen as you play for a little bit, and it really helps to have the
Pistons trail by 15.
Player skill shot turned off, and or the controller skill, and have the character skill be the defining factor. Obviously not the defining factor when you're going in for a free dunk, but let's try and pick and pop here.
Just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half.
Getting where?
Here is Ross.
So that depends on Ross's jumper skill. He's pretty good, but
really
that's
good offensive execution. Nice pick.
No matter what the announcer says, that's not actually a good shot. Falling away. Mid-range jumper. Now, one of the things that video games have kind of prefaced in real basketball is they turn toward three-pointers and dunks as the best things to do. If you play the percentages, the dunks and layups and three-pointers are significantly more valuable overall than what are called mid-range jump shots.
Right with a screen on Lynn. Matt, the pass to Wright, and
See, that was a good roll, but I did not get my point guard in good enough position. Kyle Singo's been good.
Yeah, brought it back and ripped it down.
Yeah, that's how you do it. That's nice.
Here's a free three-pointer. There are two things. Obviously, three-pointer gives more points, but the higher bounces mean there's more of a possibility for offensive rebounds. I'm not sure if the game models that, but so that's a bad mid-range jumper, even though he's wide open. So, you know, it's not the worst thing for him to take it. But. I have some of the scrubs in. Mack is not a great player. I think he's pretty good at passing and dribbling, but a long three-pointer. Should probably stop dicking around.
With this great stretch, Steve, it just seems to be a matter of time before they actually take the lead. And stolen by
Williams. It's also worth noting the Hawks are a terrible good team. Oh, God. And now it's just a four-point Hawks lead. I guess this game is getting more competitive. Their best performers today. Atlanta
calls timeout. Well, I felt like his defense was letting him down out there, guys, so he wanted to get a timeout to talk it over and try to tighten things up here.
I think if I can get Magic back in.
Part of coaching actually is making sure that momentum never gets too far away from your team. That's a good timeout.
Yeah, there's Magic.
Ross has checked in for the Hawks. Johnson comes in for Chauvinet. Johnson goes to the reverse wheel. Johnson's got 12.
Yeah, I think so, Steve. I mean, they've really dictated the action in the paint. That's been their focus, and the defense hasn't mounted much resistance at all.
Williams kicks to win. Good pass to Singler. Down to five on the shot clock. Lynn. And the layup is good. He has six.
Guys, good job working it down low and getting the high percentage look there. That's good basketball.
Right, there's actually a fourth thing that I can do, which is to have the point guard dick around. This is done using the right analog stick.
There's 39 seconds left in the third. No good.
Some people might call him vertically challenged, but tell you what, his size didn't hurt him on that rebound.
You move it up and down to do crossover dribbles, spin it to do spins. Ooh, that was exciting. Exciting all around.
He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far.
Well, you got to admire what he's been able to do at the free throw line this season, shooting better than 90% from the stripe.
And I'll tell you guys, I mean,
been outscored 19-6 in this quarter.
To see the improvement he's made in his free throw shooting in the space of just one season. I think it's been remarkable.
So, yeah.
The Pistons making a change here. Knights checked in.
One of the advantages of playing in the association with all 30 teams, though.
Ross kicks to right.
There's a perfect pick and roll. They double team the ball handler. He passed to the screener who was heading down the lane, and the pass was placed well enough, but it's an easy basket. I wish I could, you know, pause and use the telestrator, but my dreams of John Madden are not to be. As you can see, I play with 6-minute quarters.
It's time for the fourth quarter.
This tends to get to about between 45 and 60 points per game on average.
Yes, Kevin, our unbeatable game in this one. The stretch by
maybe a little more than
strong in the first quarter was something they wanted to do, and it's
half
just what the doctor ordered for them as they are in control heading to the fourth.
Half a normal NBA game statistics and
in this was when
scored.
They started to gather that steam and
blah, blah,
blah. Start rolling, guys.
Yeah, no question, Kevin. And that run changed the entire feel of this game. It wasn't just their offense.
It also means that the games last about 40 minutes for me.
And right at the start of that run, though, you could see the sudden inception.
And that's a really good sort of individual sitting
Detroit here in the fourth.
Kind of time. At GDC in 2013, I believe, Jay McGarnacle talked about the advantages of short-term play. As kind of a refreshing, a good way to refresh the brain. I don't remember exactly what the benefits were, but she definitely spoke of why there were strong benefits to playing with between half an hour and an hour of a game. Not more, not less. And I've really noticed that with this. Part of the reason that I played is not just everything I've said, but that I can have a single game that lasts for 40 minutes, and, you know, I'm happy with that. So it's kind of a good just, like, letting my brain reset. A good way to, you know, get the energy to pay attention to other things. And sometimes those other things are, you know, the metagame. That's not gonna work. See how the piston player got in front of me during the run on the basket. So I probably could have tried to pass to get out of it, but oh well. Anyway, yeah, I find it rather refreshing to just play the one game, then simulate a week to kind of see how the season is going, and then move on to whatever else I need to do. It does.
Guys, over that last break, I listened to Paul Westfall address his team. It was a pretty upbeat huddle. He said, "I'll bet they won't take us lightly next time."
I didn't expect that one to go in. Yeah, even though sometimes it just refreshes me to think about the strategic layer and who's going to get who in the draft and all that stuff. But, you know, that's just one of the dangers of having a game that you like. But yeah, I will usually do like one game a day, maybe two games. If it's particularly exciting, like if it's the playoffs, I might do three games in a day. But other than that, it's just kind of a cool, refreshing time to waste. Here's Saric. There's the screen. Back to right. Kicks it out to Johnson. Expanding his range. Magic is not a spot-up three shooter. You see those flashing things in the background? Modders out there are really interested in getting accurate on-court advertisements. So State Farm Insurance, not one of the official sponsors of the NBA 2K13 game, but I guess they advertise during Hawks game. They've turned it around. They found some energy, and they look a lot more active in the game. And, you know, there are people who want to have accurate advertisements in their games to the point where they will spend lots and lots of time working on the graphics to get those in there, which I find a pretty hilarious kind of, oh, come on. You also see things like the Gentleman Jack ad, which, there it is. And that one falls for Lynn. The Hawks have gone 2-4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. So, yeah, the game is advertising whiskey, which the original game. Johnson, the pass to right. Half a shot. It's a shot. Ooh, that one's always fun. It's not under my control. Just press the triangle button to jump, and it will automatically dunk if it's there on the rebound. Actually, have been some pretty fun animations in this, so. And glad that you, dear reader, got to see it. Oh.
Rebound, Detroit. Monroe's got his fifth rebound in this one.
Too slow on the drive there. This is actually turning into a good game. Call for that pick and roll, but it worked.
Two chances at the free throw line here.
Check out the game for Big Smooth. He has 9 points, and he's got one rejection in there also.
Now, good, solid interior defense is so important. I mean, championship teams have to play defense inside. And having shot blocking is just critical to being a successful NBA team.
So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a 3-point game.
Boy, he looked cool on both of them, didn't he? Clutch work at the line.
Hype up music kicks in here. If you get to a clutch kind of situation. Stay in the man. Yeah, they may not care in the grand scheme of things. Whether Atlanta wins, but I care that I win. Ooh, that was not a good pass. I should not have done that. I should slow it down, but that's so boring. Barring.
There's 47 seconds left in the game.
Barring that, have this pretty much locked up.
And quiet.
Yeah. It is quiet time, Clark. You got that right. That's a huge shot.
So it's still a game here. Some time run off here. And now we're in my play. Just called Magic Johnson is taller than everyone. This is not quick. You guys have to be quick. Now it'll be a intentional foul. But that should pretty much be the end of the game. Regardless of what happens. I'm going to bet the player of the game is Magic Johnson. Wow. I always like this. Sometimes it totally borks out and shows almost nothing, but this time it definitely seems to be showing things that Magic did.
Time changes, new faces, old best friends, new strangers, new watch just to keep up with the paces, new game playing off the new places. I got a feeling I could win this race. I found my pace. The only thing that you could do for me is please stay up
four blocks. That's why I line up the strategic player to go with the tactical player, because playing Magic Johnson is fun. And hopefully this explains why I enjoy playing at every level. That's all for now.